What would you think if I told you that the way you grow your family could lower your breast cancer risk? In this video, I will address one of the breast cancer risk factors that you can influence, your pregnancy history. I will tell you three family planning strategies that will reduce your chance of developing breast cancer in the future. My name is Vera. I'm a passionate cancer prevention educator and a former marketer of anti-cancer medicines. On this channel, Cancer Worry Free, you will find science-based updates without the science language on advances in cancer prevention, timely screening, and health advice to help you lower cancer risk for you and your loved ones. Breast cancer is the most common cancer to affect women, and by 2040, it will affect twice as many. There are three primary reasons for this increase. Women live longer, allowing more time for cancer to develop. More women get mammograms, allowing for more cancers to get detected. Women's lifestyles, diets, and environment are becoming more complex and less healthy. Before I dive into the three strategies, let me explain what family planning and breast cancer risk have in common. The women's breasts are the slowest developing organ in their bodies. In contrast to all other organs that form in the womb and are ready to function at birth, women's breasts begin forming in adolescence and are ready to function and make milk only after the first full-term pregnancy. Even when breasts appear fully formed on the outside, the breast cells do not mature until after the first full-term pregnancy. For some women, this period of breast formation can last as few as 5 years, while for others, as long as 30. During this lengthy formative period, the immature breast cells are very sensitive to negative influences from the external environment. Much of what we eat, drink, breathe, and take into our bodies could become our breast tissue building blocks. For example, long-term exposure to estrogen, chemicals that act like estrogen, and significant radiation doses during this formative period can increase breast cancer risk later in life. This long development process makes women's breasts a lot more susceptible to cancer than other organs. Now, let's talk about the three family planning strategies that will help you reduce your breast cancer risk. The first strategy is having multiple full-term pregnancies. Women who've had multiple full-term pregnancies have a lower breast cancer risk after menopause compared to women who had a single full-term pregnancy. Women with a single full-term pregnancy have a lower risk of breast cancer after menopause than women with zero full-term pregnancies. The correlation is clear. The larger the number of your full-term pregnancies, the lower your risk of breast cancer after menopause. Why is that? First, during pregnancies, women have no menstrual periods. This reduces a woman's lifetime exposure to hormones like estrogen, promoting breast cancer cell growth. Second, during pregnancy, women shed breast tissue. This shedding clears women's bodies of cell with potential DNA damage that, if left alone, could cause cancer. This strategy reduces breast cancer risk after menopause. How about the breast cancer risk before menopause? It is a little known fact that a full-term pregnancy increases a woman's breast cancer risk in the following 10 years. Because during the full-term pregnancy, the rapid formation of new breast cells could also cause cancer. In summary, a full-term pregnancy raises your short-term breast cancer risk and lowers your long-term after menopause. The more full-term pregnancies you have in your lifetime, the lower your breast cancer risk after menopause. The second strategy is choosing the age at which you have your first full-term pregnancy. Earlier in this video, we learned that women's breasts are vulnerable before they mature after the first full-term pregnancy. Therefore, prolonging the time until the first full-term pregnancy can raise your risk of developing breast cancer in the future. In general, the younger you are at the time you have your first full-term pregnancy, the lower your breast cancer risk. Studies have shown that women who had their first childbirth at a younger age, especially before their mid-30s, had a lower breast cancer risk than women who had their first childbirth after their mid-30s or didn't have any. Again, the protective effect of this strategy is evident 20 years after the childbirth. By choosing to postpone childbirth until later in life, you would be missing out on the opportunity to lower your breast cancer risk while achieving your family goals. Third strategy is breastfeeding. You probably know that breastfeeding gives your baby a healthy start, but that is not the only health benefit. Research shows that mothers who breastfeed lower their breast cancer risk both before and after menopause. The longer a woman breastfeeds, the stronger her protection against breast cancer and ovarian cancer. How to explain this effect? Breastfeeding has the same effect as pregnancies. It delays women's menstrual periods, thus reducing their lifetime exposure to hormones even further and extending the period of shedding breast tissue with potential DNA damage. The cancer risk reduction from breastfeeding becomes evident at 6 months and continues through the rest of your lifetime. If you are debating whether to breastfeed or how long to breastfeed, maybe knowing that breastfeeding reduces your breast cancer risk could help you make up your mind. If you liked this video so far, click the like button and comment below which one of these three strategies seems most attainable to you or your loved one. The decision to grow your family is a personal and complex one. The best family plan would vary from person to person, based on their health, their support system, socioeconomic circumstances, and other parallel needs and pursuits. It would be understandable if one would not be able to apply all three strategies. Here are some examples of how to apply these strategies to your best advantage. If you already have high risk factors for breast cancer, then you can try to start growing your family at a younger age or extend your breastfeeding period. If you have your first full-term pregnancy after the age of 35, you can counter that by extending your breastfeeding period for as long as possible. All women should begin getting screened for breast cancer with annual mammograms no later than 40 years old. However, if you didn't have a full-term pregnancy or you had one after 35, you could use this information to negotiate with your doctor and with your insurance company getting screened at a younger age. I'm sharing these three strategies to help you integrate them into your family planning so you can lower your breast cancer risk. I'm not recommending getting pregnant as a cancer prevention measure only. There are other ways to lower breast cancer risk, which I will share in my future videos. If you found this video helpful, click the like button, comment below, share the link with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and click the notification bell so you get my updates as soon as I post them. I will see you in the next video. Until then, worry less and live more.